Alright guys, we are back, ready to continue. So the first thing we're doing, let's go by the shrine and level on up our body some more. Then I want to check out that new guardian spirit we got, Suzaku. Activate living weapon, no life. So I guess it just works if you have no life. It's like a, I mean, it's a phoenix, so yeah, it makes sense. Amrita earned using living weapon, 25%. So that, along with extraction, would probably be pretty dirty. 15% fire damage. And auto charge, Amrita gauge, and critical, 21. Pretty cool for like a fight to the death type style. Anyway, we're going to go do the dojo, and we're going to do a clash of sickles. Get some badass Kusarigama skill. So this is just a you versus me. Prepare for abuse. Gotcha. Shit, that attack buff. Gotcha again. Two can play this game. Oh, damn. Blocking hard. Gotcha.
Jōzen mizu no gotoshi. Rei to chōwase shi sono chikara.
I don't know why we're talking about working with spirits. This was a Kusarigama thing, but all right, dude, whatever you say. Sure, I have great spirit mastery. New mystic art, Kusarigama, has been unlocked. Okay, so these are now unlocked. Increase both the attack damage and key damage caused by the sickle, while also reducing the amount of key used. That's insane. I need that. Increase both the attack damage and key damage caused by the metal weight. I also need that. So if I were to respec, I don't even know if I can respec. Actually, I could buy a thing. Let me see where I would pull skills from. I never fucking use Summer Twilight. I should, though. Crimson Flurry would give me 7 points back. I wouldn't use that. Need that. Need that. I don't like Retreating Strike, but I like Chain Pull. So, I could get 7 points back from, damn, I want Armor Piercer too, though. And 7 points would probably go there. I really like Blade Spin. Is there any, Samurai Locks I can take? I think I just need to start using my Katana to get proficiency with it, to unlock those, because those are really fucking good. Like, it's basically worth doing a respec just to get those. I mean, how much damage was that? It just increases the damage, but... I mean, yeah, both of these need to happen. That's just a lot of points. Anyway, that's 92, this is 91. Let's do this one first. Alright, knock out these two side missions, and then, I know I can pick up a respec with Glory, so I might do that just to pick up those skills, because they seem pretty significant. I'd probably get, I mean, if I can only afford one, if I take the stuff from Crimson Flurry to get one, it's probably going to be the metal weight instead of the sickle, because... I mean, that's metal weight. That's all metal weight. Like, there's one sickle attack in there. See, this one is metal weight, mostly. Even this is... Yeah, I gotta get that metal weight skill. I think, like, the only attack I really have... I mean, even Crimson Flurry, I think, is mostly all metal weight. The only, like, pure sickle is... That's like the only like pure sickle attack I think I have on this character. Which actually I didn't even look to see. Let's see if it's any good. I should really get some new weapons. Damn. That is a really big bonus. What would I lose with the 7-piece? Ninjutsu damage bonus A. I really don't want to give that up. But 123 compared to 82. Oh, God. We're going to have to do some familiarity, soul forging type shit, I think. Is this like death water? No, it's not. Stone? Probably wouldn't hurt to do a respec either, just to finer tune some things. Like, I'm pretty comfortable with my spec, all in all. I mean, I would abandon Crimson Flurry, but that's about it. Like, that's the only skill that I have that I'm kind of like, eh, I don't really need you. Everything else, I'd definitely use. I think I might rework some of the passives I take. Like, I'd put more value into the final blow damage over the damage from behind. I mean, damage from behind is good, but I'm constantly utilizing the final blow damage. But then again, it's kind of a question of, you know, is like one, for example, listen here, dickhead. Final blow damage is more like an anti-humanoid type thing. Ow. Wow. Fuck you. Oh, there's a bunch of treasure chests. Let me snatch them all up. I should have known that was going to happen. Like, as soon as I started fighting that guy, just the sheer resistance of that Kappa should have been a pretty clear sign that he was the mission success. For a second, I thought it was a soul stone I couldn't pick up. I was like, fuck that! I will pick up every soul stone. I'm rid of pop. Damn right, I'm gonna pick them all up. Where is this last one? Is it? What is it? It's gotta be above. Wait, stuff over there. But how do I get to this last treasure chest? What the hell? Am I overlooking it? Oh, here we go. There it is. This is where we started, so it's just an alternate approach I could have taken, it looks like. Right, and the only other place, there's another ship over here. Explore that real fast. I mean, honestly, I'm probably better off just crafting a whole new set. Just because I think the price to soul match my Kusarigama is gonna be like outrageous, like 300,000, but I know somebody figured out that familiarity does have a pretty large impact on it, so I'm gonna try and take that other Kusarigama, the one I got from the mission, and I'll try and I'll boost the familiarity up with that using wheat stones, and then hopefully price won't be too bad, and I can still utilize my set, but, I mean, the only problem with, like, ideally, I could just, you know, be like, oh, okay, let me just reforge the whole damn thing, you know, reforge a whole new set completely from scratch, because a lot of my gear is probably, pretty shit level. Chest that I missed. No. Where the hell is this chest at? But I mean, I did so much reforging for like fucking super ideal stats. I don't know what's in that last chest, but I'm not gonna try and hunt it down. I don't care that much. I feel like between crafting the gear and then reforging for ideal stats, I feel like it's just gonna take too damn long. And I really don't want to pass up on the ninja set because, like, it's just so good. Like, it's so good. I mean, especially right now, like, let me see. I am 92. Most of my gear is 70s. And it doesn't even matter. That's how good that ninja set is. Silent Crow. Disappearing from bathhouses, then returning as corpses. Yeah, that's not normal. Let's go whoop some ass. So I'm gonna do that. Oh, it's this place. Fuck, bathhouse. This might take a while, actually. Well, boys, settle in. It's gonna be a long episode. But yeah, I think after this, I'm gonna respec to what's gonna be my final spec for this character. And then on top of that, probably spend some time crafting up new gear. Well, it looks like the... looks like that's like infected or something. How are people dying? Fell to death. Fell to death. Fell to death. Okay. Apparently falling to death seems to be the theme of the season. Fell to death. Fell to death. What the hell? Why is everyone falling to death? Cut down by Yokai. Shit! That attack probably would have put me into the cut down by Yokai category. Hunt down wood tiles again. Damn it. We're gonna go as fast as we can, despite that. Hey, as it for you. Those things aren't hard, but I wish I could figure out what the, like, what the gimmick is to just really shit all over them, you know?
Ah!
do kind of like the idea of using a new Kusarigama just because it has Earth on it with Tile 2. Like, Earth is just... I mean, Wind's not bad, but I think ideally I want Water or I want Earth, because Earth increases all key costs. My key costs are super fucking low. So, it's like I already have a massive advantage over everything I fight when it comes to key, and Earth just capitalizes on that even more. Wind focuses on reducing the enemy's damage. Need to find a drop down for that. Where the hell is the drop down? Which, like, it's okay. You know, I'm squishy, so on one hand, you could argue, oh, wind's good, because if you get hit, you know, it's not going to instantly kill you. But at the same time, you know, I'm not exactly getting hit a lot. Like, 90% of the time. I mean, unless it's like I'm fighting a boss and I haven't fought him before, and I'm still learning, you know, what his move patterns are, kind of like the boss we fought in the previous episode. Like, except for cases like that, you know, I'm not really getting hit all that much. Like, I'm dodging everything. I got A agility. There's no reason to not dodge. So, I feel like wind's a little kind of meh. Fire. Fire's good. I like fire. It's also completely unnecessary because of the fact that I have a shit ton of bombs. And then the last up choice is water. Which water isn't really needed for me. Or, I mean, water is a decent choice because reducing enemies' physical reducing their physical defense just lets me smash more shit with my Kusarigama. Looks like I like that. So in short, I really need to get either earth or water. Wind's not bad. Going through the whole process of reforging to try and get one of those is kind of iffy. I'd be much better off just using the one that just dropped with earth. It did look badass too. I need one more fucking tile. I don't know why I bothered trying. So the last time I did this shitty mission, it was... No, it's not it. It'll be purple. I don't know why I got excited for a second. I was like, is that it? No, it's not it. Oh, damn it. It was up there. That might be it in that chest. There. Sushi's Magatama. I can boost the blacksmith. That's always nice. Well, one was over here. I feel like I've explored this second floor thoroughly. Let me go back up to the third floor real fast. I fucking hate this place. Bathhouse. There it is. That's it. It's gotta be it. There we go. Didn't even think to look in here, because the last time I came here, there was fucking nothing. I mean, there was no enemies, you know? You see a zone that has zero enemies, and you're kind of like, Alright, nothing important here. Otherwise, the game will be flooding with enemies. Might as well pray up. Damn, I got three of these fuckers. Should actually save those. I could probably use those for just instant Emrita gauge. I don't know why I'm going so high on body. It's completely unnecessary. What do we got? Hina, what are you doing here? You silly little bitch. I can't believe that hit me. Damn, dude. Just kidding, bitch. Oh, no, she's actually gonna get off that attack. Motherfucker. Bitch! Get that weak shit out of here. Dude.
またあの怪しは死んだか。いや、助かったよ。そのかんざし良かった。すまんね。代わりと言ってはなんだが、こいつをやるよ。Okay.
I'll take Fame Ninja Locks. I don't know what the hairpin was even for, but I'm all about Fame Ninja Locks. It gives me enough points to unlock the thing I wanted. And then I can take the points out of Crimson Flurry to unlock both, and it'll be baller. I mean, the idea of the Ninja Locks is kind of funny. Like, I'm a famous ninja. Here, let me cut my hair off and eat this, and you'll get powerful. I got that bellowing Tenryu thing looks badass. Anyway, up next we go to Sekigahara. So that's going to be really badass. But before that, obviously I got to do some spec changing. So thanks for coming by, guys. Hope you're enjoying Nioh. Working our way through. I mean, looking at the country map, there can only be two more regions at most. Like, you couldn't fit more than two there. But I think that's one. I don't know. Maybe two. Either way. Stay tuned, and we'll catch you guys next time with more.